A note on Bowfinger. A comedy with two superstars, two of the best comedians ever, Steve Martin and Eddie Murphy. Steve Martin is Bowfinger. He has a studio to make films, but the problem is he has no money personally. He's bankrupt, and the studio has only about 2,400 and some dollars in the account. Money which he saved ever since he was something like 5. He put a month $1 in the account, and the idea was he would make movies, movies which of course cost much more. The other giant of comedy, Eddie Murphy, is Keith Ramsey and Jeff Ramsey. He's playing both brothers. There's also Heather Graham. I've seen her recently on Drugstore Cowboy. In fact, I noted on Drugstore Cowboy only yesterday. She was excellent. She's a great actress. She didn't have all that many leading, well, I can't think of any, in fact, leading roles, but she's good when she is supporting, she's in a supporting role. Hangover also comes to mind, and Boogie Nights. In Boogie Nights, she was also excellent as Roller Girl. Here she's Daisy, and she comes to Hollywood like so many thousands, maybe tens, hundreds of thousands of people. Looking for fame and a part in a motion picture, and that's tough with so many, with such a huge competition. It's next to impossible to make it. She's ready though to do anything, sleep with any and all of the crew actually, because there is a film, there is an attempt to produce a film by hook or by crook. The accountant of Bowfinger Pictures has a script, a science fiction idea with an alien invasion, and Bowfinger, aka Steve Martin, thinks this is the key, and they may even get an Oscar or a few. With no money, no star to play in, they have only Heather Graham, Daisy, and she's lovely, but they try and get to Ramsey, Kit Ramsey, who is a star, and his presence would just propel the film, would mean so much, would launch, really, open, as they say, understand, it's a star would open a film in theaters. Terrence Stamp is sort of a guru for this Kit Ramsey. Also on this wonderful actor I've noted recently, as he played with Hugo Weaving. Guy Pearce in Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, extraordinary, flamboyant, outstanding film, comedy. He was Bernadette, transsexual, Terrence Stamp. There's also Robert Downey Jr., so the cast is fantastic for this film. And indeed, they try and we enter comedy territory as we see the crew trying to, first of all, to convince Kit Ramsey, and when they couldn't, follow him, chase him, do whatever it takes, including taking shots with him unaware that he is being filmed. He would be in a motion picture. And then they find his brother, and they use him, even if the man is is, alas, mentally challenged. He has an IQ of, I don't know, 70. I understand that's a limit. 70, was it? Below 71 is, I don't know the medical term, idiot. Or, but in legal cases, I think that's when they consider a case in a different light, a different. I mean, the one committing this crime still has a. Has to serve a penalty of some kind, but it's a threshold. Indeed, in some cases, they criticize the fact that, for instance, that some men, it's mostly men, almost always men, actually, killed others. But it was a debate because their IQ was so low that many considered, well, they're too stupid to know what they're doing. Unable to with the low IQ, maybe research would be more research would be needed to see where we place the limit, if they place a limit. Maybe they'd give up executions altogether. Not in a number of countries anyway. They can establish that they don't really know. They don't have equivalent of madness, you know, a madman. Doesn't know, and he ends up in a lunatic asylum if he commits a crime. And he's mad. Anyway, to return, they put poor Chief Ramsey in the position we're in a scene. I remember that was both funny and terrifying. He has to cross a busy highway, so there are like hundreds of cars. Every 30 seconds going either way, and he's crossing this highway. And he does it because he doesn't.